Eminem has dropped a lot of classic songs over the years, but there is one that we haven't done on this channel that has been highly requested. It's definitely one of his most iconic. It's one of those that if you need to get through a struggle, you need that just little extra kick. It's Soldier. One. I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier. Man, I almost forgot just how gritty that distortion is. You know, it's kind of out wide, atmospheric, and then you just have other musical elements cutting through that melody, that unforgettable dun, 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 the bass as it starts to just reverberate, and Eminem just keeps it simple to start with. You know, drop down cadence, smooth sort of delivery, I'm a soldier. Just let that sink in as we kind of set the tone, and then it gets into attack mode. I'm a soldier. Never was a thug, just infatuated with guns. Never was a gangster till I graduated to one and got the rap of a... Infatuated with guns, graduated to one. We talk about the multi-syllable schemes from M, and what does he do? Comes in with a smooth 6-7 syllable scheme right away. And that statement, never was a thug till I graduated to one. And in this case, I take it as, you know, context is everything. So from this perspective, you know, we don't really get like a ton of gangster rap from Eminem. Definitely when 50 jumped on board and you saw like the disses with Ja Rule and Benzino, you got a more gangster type of Eminem. But for me, what happened was M was getting just completely hounded in the media for, you know, carrying a weapon, concealing one, for pistol whipping John Guerra. So a lot of people were coming at him like, oh, he's a thug, he's a gangster, look at him, he's promoting violence. So what does Eminem do? You know, take that shit that people want to diss you with and wear it like armor. So for me, he kind of took all that critique and he's like, you know what, I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna spin it back on him. I'll give you some gangster shit and I'll give you some stuff that the kids are gonna bump, that I can market, that I can continue to win on, taking a negative and flipping it around to a positive. And then it's an interesting line too. Never was a gangster just infatuated with guns. Because is there a comma on that? Never was a gangster, comma, infatuated with guns. So I never was a gangster. But that comma there, if it separates, it would be meaning like he's just infatuated with guns. He's always had a gun infatuation. It's kind of like a fetish. You know, he likes to run around shooting off his AK-47. Look out, Mariah Carey. Or it could be along the lines of never was a gangster infatuated with guns. So he's not that gangster and gangsters who are typically infatuated with guns. See how it could kind of go either way depending on if there's a comma there or not, but it's not like you could sit there and rap, yeah, comma, pause, breaking point, right there within the lyricism. But still, dope setup by M. Never was a thug, just infatuated with guns. Never was a gangster till I graduated to one and got the rap of a villain, the weapon concealing. Took the image of a thug, captured a villain, willing to stick out my neck for respect if it meant life. There it is. Took the image of a thug, kept shit appealing. We just touched on that. Notice, rep of a villain, weapon concealing, kept shit appealing. Nice A to B again. The multi-syllable rhymes, baby, is smooth. Was a gangster till I graduated to one and got the rep of a villain, the weapon concealing. Took the image of a thug, kept shit appealing, willing to stick out my neck for respect if it meant life or death. Never lived to regret what I said. When you're me, people just wanna see if it's true, if it's you, what you say in your rap, what you do. So that if it's me, if it's true, what you do? I love it's like do-do-do, do-do-do, do-do-do. Sort of like that. I sit back with this pack and zigzags and this weed. You see how Eminem is using this aggressive cadence and style. In every couple syllables, he punches and he comes back, punches. Do-do-do-do, do-do-do-do. And he just very cool flow that he's found on this. Weapon concealing, step shed a billing. Kept it concealing. I don't know what that second line was. I just made up shit. Thank you, Merriam-Webster. I run it. Me, people just want to see if it's true, if it's you. What you say in your rap, what you do, so they feel. It's part of your obligation to fulfill. When they see you on the streets, face to face, and you're for real. In confrontation, ain't no conversation. If you feel you're in violation, any hesitation to get you killed. If you really kill it, you conceal it, reveal it. Being reasonable will leave you full of... If you feel it, kill it. If you conceal it, reveal it. Obviously, I take that as Eminem trolling because, again, for him, having a concealed weapon. And in this case, he's saying, look, there's no time for talking.
right? Instincts are what keep you alive. It's survival of the fittest out in these streets. So fucking pull it. And again, you got to look at sort of the meta message here. For me, Eminem going in, making a song about being a soldier, talking about this violence, almost like, all right, you want to critique me for like glorifying violence? Well, fuck it. Here's your violence, people.
Takes it to get you killed. If you feel it, kill it. You can seal it, reveal it. Being reasonable will leave you full of bullets. Pull it, squeeze it till it's empty. Tempt me, push me, pussies. I need a good reason to give this trigger a good squeeze.
I'm a soldier. These shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never slip or stumble.
I'm a soldier.
These shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never stumble.
I think what I love about this, you talk about dynamics to being a musician. And he's got such an aggressive verse. And we highlighted that, like the growly throat delivery, very punchy, very over-accentuated on lines. So what's really dope is that he kind of peels it back with his hook and it gets smoother. And it's almost like sing-songy M. My soul just won't budge or hold up. I will never crumble. See, like he's more just laid back in the pocket. And I think that sort of dynamic is really dope. Like, you could do it two ways. Like, you could have a softer verse and be, like, more mellow and then get, like, aggressive on the hook. Or do it this way. Like, super aggressive verse and then kind of mellow it out on the hook and, like, get it kind of chanty. And you hear, like, the soldier marching in the background, adding more to the theme of the message.
I'm a soldier. Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never stumble. Gets me off like my lawyers when the fucking judge lets me off.
Oh, oh man, Eminem just owning the trolling right now. I mean, especially at this time too, he was going shit. He was getting sued by moms, he was getting sued by Kim, he was getting sued by anyone who was trying to get a dollar out of him. And Eminem, hey man, power of a good legal team. Motherfuckers getting off like Johnny Cochran and OJ, baby. Man's getting away with murder.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never stumble. I love pissing you off, gets me off. Like my lawyers when the fucking judge lets me off. All you motherfuckers gotta do is set me off. I'm violating all the motherfucking pets be off. I'm a lit fuse, anything I do, bitch, it's news. Pistol whipping motherfucking bouncer 6'2". Who needs bullets soon?
Pistol whipping bouncer 6'2", and this is a theme he talks about on Sync for the Moment, Say Goodbye to Hollywood. You know, the whole incident when he saw Kim kissing the bouncer, John Guerra, and Eminem just goes crazy. But in Sync for the Moment, Eminem says, you're full of shit too, Guerra. That was a fist that hit you, meaning I punched you, right? I didn't pistol whip you. But the media outlets and everybody ran with it like he pistol whipped him. So I take this as, you know, everything he does is news, right? Everything he does gets turned into a story, something for clicks. Oh, wow. Is he like a fortune teller? Because doesn't that just bode well for today? I mean, still to this day, every time someone mentions Eminem, it gets so many views and clicks and the media outlets go crazy. How can we spin this? How can we make a story out of this? But in this case, I don't think he's literally saying that he pistol whipped him, because he wouldn't have said In Sync for the Moment, which is more of like his raw, honest song, right? When he's kind of bearing more to us. Like, he wouldn't have said that he just hit him with a fist. I take him for his word on that, right? So for me, the reason this line is here and why that contradiction exists is because he's saying that just to piss people off again, to set them off further. Because how does he set up this verse? You know, I love pissing you off. It gets me off. Like, I'm over here like fucking masturbating every time you get angry. How you feel about that?
Thing I do, bitch, it's news. Pistol whipping motherfucking bouncer 6'2". Who needs bullets? As soon as I pull it, you sweat bullets.
Nah. And Eminem, another favorite rhyming technique of him is to take an idiom, take a saying that we all have and to interpret it literally and then to also use it to spin wordplay and a double out of it. So this time, instead of bullets, like literal bullets, you're sweating bullets, you're so nervous. He just pulls out the gun and you start sweating and getting nervous. That's the only bullets that he needs. It's you sweating bullets.
Pets be off. I'm a lit fuse. Anything I do, bitch, it's news. Pistol whipping motherfucking bouncer 6'2". Who needs bullets? As soon as I pull it, you sweat bullets. An excellent method to get rid of the next.
Sweat bullets and excellent. I just love the way he made excellent rhyme with sweat bullets because of that over enunciation and that technique that we talked about.
Who needs bullets? As soon as I pull it, you sweat bullets. An excellent method to get rid of the next bully. It's actually better because instead of you murdering, you can hurt him and come back. Again, it kicked dirt in him. Mr. Corn, salt in the wounds. Salt and get sued. You can smell the lawsuit as soon as I walk in the room.
Can smell the lawsuit soon as I waltz in the room. Yeah, it's pouring salt in the wound. If you don't kill him, you can keep coming back and terrifying him.
Salt in the wounds, salt in smell the lawsuit soon as I walked in the room.
And then Assault and Get Sued again, the Guerra Assault. He's playing off of that, trolling yet again.
Stops, calls the cops. All you see is bitches coming out their hall to tops, running and ducking out the high rise parking lot. You'll all get shot, whether it's your fault or not. Just I'm a soldier.
Again, I love that because you got to think about the balls on this man, right? The Hot Rocks parking lot, he's shooting. So he's yet again using his music to over-exaggerate because he didn't pull out his gun and start shooting everywhere when the situation happened. But now he's taking this and he's using the satire of his music and the over-exaggeration to express it through his art, to express his anger, to unleash, to let out. And what's this going to do? This is going to piss off a lot of people. It's going to open a lot of eyes again because it's like, wow, this motherfucker's crazy. But then there's still that difference between what he's saying on the track and what's happening in real life. You see that sort of connection, but also that disconnect that he's representing?
Shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never slip or stumble.
I'm a soldier.
These shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never stumble.
You forget how dope of a hook this is. I mean, this is just one of those motivational ass hooks. You know what I mean? Like, this is one of those when you need that little bit of strength, that little bit of sort of kick in the ass to keep rolling, to keep moving forward, to go with the punches. Put this motherfucking song on.
Slow so these kids know that I'm talking to them. Give it back to these damn.
Hang on.
I will never stumble. I spit it slow so these kids know that I'm talking to them. Give it back to these damn critics and sock it to them. I'm like a dog with a little bit of pop influence. I spew it and look how I got you bitches rocking to it.
Like a thug with a little bit. He even said it kind of like Pac saying thug, like just holding it out in that way, paying homage to one of the greats, Tupac. Rest in peace.
Kids know that I'm talking to him. Give it back to these damn critics and sock it to him. I'm like a thug with a little bit of Pac influence. I spew it and look how I got you bitches rocking to it. You motherfuckers can never do it like I can do it. Don't even try it. You look stupid. Do not pursue it. Don't ever in your life try to knock the truest. I spit the illest shit ever been tried to do it. So ticket talk.
Love that little record scratch. Goes ticky tock on the clock, man. Listen to Kim as she slurps on a cock. Kim cheating on him.
Sound ticks on the clock. Listen to the sound of Kim as she licks on a cock. Listen to the sound of me spilling my heart through his pen. Motherfuckers know that I'll never be marshaled again.
One of my favorite lines right there. So I spill my heart through this pen. Motherfuckers know I'll never be Marshall again. Because I'm at this level. I'm at this status now of celebrity that people only see me as Eminem. Or they see me as my alter ego, Slim Shady. Like, they don't necessarily know who the real Marshall Mathers is. And I think that's one of the overall themes of this track, right? You want to call me a gangster. You want to call me a thug. You want to say I do all this wild shit. Like, I'm going to go shoot up everybody out in the streets. But you don't know the other side. You don't know where this anger comes from that I express through my art form. You don't know the pain. You don't know the man that is Marshall. And in this case, like, it's just become so overwhelming. Like, I feel like the ship is set sailed. He'll never will be Marshall on his own again.
Controversy until I retire my jersey. Till the fire inside dies and expires at 30. And Lord have mercy on any more of these rappers that burst me and put a curse on authorities in the face of adversity. I'm a soldier.
Retiring jerseys, man. I mean, I wish we could retire rappers' jerseys like MJ and some of the greats, man. Eminem, 23 all day.
Shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never slip or stumble.
I'm a soldier.
These shoulders hold up so much, they won't budge. I'll never fall or fold up.
I'm a soldier.
Even if my collarbones crush or crumble, I will never stumble.
And then that outro when he goes left, right, left, and he does the soldier march. And again, you just hear the sound of like troops marching. And this is Eminem prepared for war. This is Eminem showing us that darker, grittier side to his nature. And I feel like this is why it makes this album one of the greatest albums, because you get a lot of different portraits of M. You get some amazing themes on this album, some explorations from Sing to the Moment to Cleaning Out My Closet to then a song like Soldier. Definitely fits in and gives you just a different vibe and feel to it. And man, step in line, put the combat boots on. Eminem, you were not so certified. Hope you guys liked today's video. If you did, do me a huge favor, guys. Support channel directly. Subscribe with notifications on. It really, really does go a long way. Also, leave a comment for the algorithm. Leave a like. It helps out a lot, guys. I love you. Stay safe. Stay positive. I'll catch you again.